child is working. You and I are okay if a 6-year-old girl is raped by a 15-year-old boy. We're okay. Many cases. What about that? ऐसे बड़ी बड़ी देश में ऐसे छोटी छोटी बात होती है. Have it become very normal? Has abuse against children become normal? This was my first question for all of you. Dear young friends, today I want you to use your brain a little bit to think about a few issues. First issue, children in our society require a safe childhood. We as a civilized society, I have failed utterly, miserably in providing a safe childhood for our children. I don't know how many of you are aware, in the last 1 year, the amount of abuses against children in Hyderabad has increased dramatically. Are you aware of that? Have you read about the cases of small children being abused in their houses? We did a survey for UNICEF about 2 years back. 61% of children said they do not feel safe at home. 61% of children. Why? Abuse. What kind of abuse? All kinds of abuse. We rescued a 13-year-old girl. She was studying 8th class in a very good private education, private school. She ran away from home. You know why? Father abusing his own daughter. Story? Yeah. Like, real story. She told her brother, brother said, okay, let it begin. Mother is away, mother said, what can I do? Grandmother said, fine, we'll talk to him. Nothing happened. She bore it for about 8 months. She knew nothing was going to change. Am I talking about the one extreme case? No. I'm talking of one of the many cases that happen in our society. But we want our families to be safe. We want everything around us to be safe. Why? Because my life is important enough. We find it easier to know what is happening somewhere out there, but we do not know what's happening in the person who's sitting right beside me. People commit suicides. And he said, but I met him yesterday, he was okay. Huh? Yeah, he was okay. That's what you thought. That's what you thought. He was okay. Because you become so conditioned today. It's like, you know, I meet you, I say, hi, how are you? What do you know what he say? Fine, thank you. Fine, thank you. You might be having 103 temperature, but you're fine, thank you. And after that you say, actually no, I have temperature. But he said, fine, thank you. But we are all taught to say, fine, thank you. The biggest irony in our society is this fine, thank you. We live life like machines. One thing after the other, one thing after the other. And we somewhere down the line, we have lost a sense of what we are born for. Somebody wants to ask young college students, what do you think you will become? No, I'll become a computer engineer, I'll become that, I'll become the doctor. So are you born to become a computer engineer? Are you born to become a software engineer? God bless you. Plenty of software engineers. Plenty of software engineers. The world doesn't need another. The world needs human beings. Courage, determination, bent and pivot of commitment and conscience. We need people who can walk on the pages of history and leave your standard footprints of the standard of time. We don't need our agenda. We don't need people. People come, people die, and they'll be gone. Are you born for that? If you are born for that, God bless you. It was much better if you hadn't been in trouble. Because your life, you're wasted. A life that is wasted is a crime. if you and I are very busy chasing those butterflies, chasing those balloons of career, and you think that is your life, perfect. If that is what you think your life is, if you think your life is about that one, I, if I get my thing, that cover is my life, then it's a little bit like. If you think your life is that, if you get your feet there, perfect. Dear young friends, the challenge for you and me today is, ask yourself a question, why am I born? What am I supposed to do? This is a very beautiful thing of human life. None of us who are born just for nothing. We are not just born for nothing. So stop comparing yourself with somebody else. Stop comparing yourself to somebody else and say, you know, I am not like him, I am not like her. Thank God you are not like him.